Welcome to an example on how to graph a parabola when the equation is given in standard form. The first thing we should recognize about our equation is that the x part is squared, which means the parabola will have a vertical axis of symmetry, or vertical axis, which means the parabola will open up or down. So let's go ahead and make a note of that. We'll have a vertical axis. And before we find all these key characteristics of a parabola, let's do a quick review. Again, if the x part of the equation is being squared, we have a vertical axis or axis of symmetry, which in this case would be this vertical line here. The axis will have an equation of x equals h, which we can obtain from the equation here. The vertex of the parabola, or this point here, which is either the lowest point on the parabola if it opens up, or the highest point on the parabola if it opens down, has coordinates hk, which again we can obtain from the equation. Next, the value of a will tell us whether the parabola opens up or down. If a is positive, the parabola opens up, as we see here. If a is negative, the parabola opens down. And then the absolute value of a gives us enough information to find all the other key components of our parabola. The distance from the vertex to the focus is equal to the absolute value of a. So this distance here is equal to the absolute value of a, which means we can find the coordinates of the focus by adding a to the y-coordinate of the vertex. And then the distance from the vertex to the directrix, or this horizontal line, is also equal to the absolute value of a, which means the equation of the directrix would be y equals k minus a. And then finally, the absolute value of 4a gives us the length of the latus rectum, or focal diameter, which is this segment here. The focal diameter, or latus rectum, is parallel to the directrix, passes through the focus with endpoints on the parabola. So if we know the length of this segment, we can then find the coordinates of the endpoints, which will help us sketch a more accurate parabola. So going back to our example, we know we have a vertical axis, so let's go ahead and find the value of a. Well, we know 4a must equal 8. So if we divide both sides by 4, we know that a is equal to positive 2, which is greater than 0, which means our parabola will open up. Now I'll start to find these key characteristics of our parabola. So the vertex has coordinates hk. Since we have the quantity x minus 2, the x coordinate is positive 2. And since we have the quantity y plus 3, the y coordinate is negative 3. Let's go ahead and plot the vertex. So 2, negative 3 would be here. Let's go ahead and label this point V for vertex. And because we know the parabola opens up, let's go ahead and make a very rough sketch of the parabola now, which will help us find these other key components of our parabola. So if we know it opens up, or looks something like this, we know the focus would be inside the parabola, absolute value of a units above the vertex. Well, the absolute value of a is positive 2, which means our focus will be 2 units above the vertex, or this point here. So to find the coordinates of the focus, we can see we'll have to add 2 to the y-coordinate of the vertex. Well, negative 3 plus 2 is negative 1, so the focus has coordinates to negative 1. Which we can also verify from the graph. And then our directrix will be 2 units below the vertex, so the directrix would pass through this point, and it would be a horizontal line, so it would be this line here. Well, we can see the equation would be y equals negative 5. Another way to obtain this equation would be to subtract 2 from the y-coordinate of the vertex. Notice negative 3 minus 2 is equal to negative 5. And then for the equation of the axis, or axis of symmetry, that would be a vertical line that cuts this parabola in half, passing through the focus and the vertex. So the axis would be this vertical line here. Which we can see would be x equals 2. Notice how this is also the x-coordinate of the vertex. And then finally, we'll find the endpoints of the focal diameter, or latus rectum, which will also help us make a more accurate sketch of our parabola. Well, the length of the latus rectum is the absolute value of 4a, which would be the absolute value of 8, which is equal to 8. So from the focus, we'll plot 1.4 units to the right, and another 4 units to the left of the focus, which would be here. Notice how this segment would have a length of 8 units, which means we'd have to add and subtract 4 from the x-coordinate of the focus to find these coordinates. We can just look on the coordinate plane. Notice how this point would be 6, negative 1. And the other endpoint is negative 2, negative 1. Or again, looking at the focus, notice that 2 plus 4 would be 6. So we have 6, negative 1. And 2 minus 4, it would give us negative 2, negative 1. So we'll finish by sketching a more accurate graph. We know the parabola must pass through the two endpoints of the latus rectum, so the parabola would look something like this. If we wanted a more accurate sketch, we could find more points, we could find the intercepts, or just make a table of values. Okay, I hope you found this explanation helpful.